My name is Sergio Peña, and I will be talking about the sign language interpreters in Mexico and how this has impacted the United States. As many other countries, it is the hearing children of deaf parents that were the first sign language interpreters of our country. Later, some of the religious organizations were the ones that were interpreting their meetings or their religious meetings into sign language. Although this interpreting method that was being used at that time tended to be more a transliteration than interpretation. The deaf people, or many of the deaf people that were attending those services, did not understand the message that was being conveyed. So they thought that the sermon or the discourse that was being presented was just beyond their knowledge or beyond their understanding. The interpreters did recognize that when they would turn over and talk to their deaf friends, it was a different way of communicating than when they would step up and start interpreting. It was a different style. So they figured that when you interpret, that was a formal way of signing, and then when you would talk to deaf friends or deaf people, that was an informal way of conversation. The language was just a different kind of language. One was formal, one was informal, and deaf and interpreters, including, were accepting that issue or accepting that explanation for the non-comprehension of the message. As time went by, some of the interpreters started receiving some kind of training in San Diego, California. They crossed the border, they took some workshops with religious interpretation, and they found out that it wasn't the case. The transliteration or going sign by word was not a real interpretation. They were not conveying accuracy in the message they were being interpreting. Now, you got to understand that Mexico had very little experience at that time with interpreters. It's a monolingual country at the most cases or most areas of the country. It's not exposed to the variety of languages that the United States has. The United States is used to and has a lot of experience working with interpreters of many different languages. Mexico is a Spanish-speaking country, except for some small communities where they use different kinds of dialects. So in the case of interpreting experience, it was very, very little. So there's no way to get enough information to apply it to the interpreters that were doing the sign language interpretation at that time. So these interpreters that were receiving training from the United States came back to Mexico and started sharing the information and started training other interpreters that were going word by word or doing a transliteration instead of an interpretation of meaning and accuracy. So as this new method of interpretation was being used, less transliteration was being accepted and more interpretation was being done instead. Now, these new qualified interpreters were really grateful and happy, including the deaf people that were now understanding what was going on in the message that was being transmitted at that time. So what happened, one of the interpreters from Mexico City attended a Latin America conference in Santa Fe, Bogota, Colombia, to receive some kind of training. And under their instruction, he came back to Mexico to establish the first sign language interpreter association or organization that was going to be coordinating the interpreters nationwide. There were at that time many organizations, but they were all deaf organizations, not an interpreters organization. So on April 21st through the 23rd of 1995, a group of interpreters gathered in Mexico City to establish this new interpreters organization according to what the Latin America convention was said to do, it each one of them in their own country. So at this date, the new organization called ANILS, which stands for Asociación Nacional de Intérpretes de la Lengua de Signos, was established and set up at that time. Now, this new organization, or this interpreters organization, since then has been giving workshops, has continued to analyze or hire new linguistics to analyze what is now Mexican Sign Language, or what we call LSM. This new investigation has proved that deaf people have a language, a natural language, that interpreters should follow according to what they use in their communities. This new organization established a new code of ethics for interpreters, professional development for interpreters, new kind of certification that would recognize the interpreters that this organization was approving. Now, at this time, this organization is focusing on the educational area and the appropriate use of the Mexican Sign Language that uses the deaf community in Mexico. Now, ANILS is a new organization, and it's still trying to establish a lot of services, but many of the interpreters have not yet joined this organization, and they have their own private service, freelance interpreting services, or some of the government agencies have their own list of interpreters that they use, sign language interpreters, of course. So approximately, we feel that we have 35 qualified sign language interpreters. Among them, we have a few CODAs, or Child of Deaf Adults. At this time, we have a lot to do to train and to go into professional development with the interpreters of the deaf in Mexico. There is a lot of need of this, especially to create an interpreter training program, and schools are talking about it. Most of the private schools are talking about establishing new programs that can function as an interpreter training program, and some of them are in Baja California, some of them are in Mexico City, the city of Monterrey, and the state of Sonora, and many other states maybe are doing the same thing. They are giving a lot of support to this. Now, we're requiring and we're asking that other countries get involved in Mexico to give us this backup information. Some of them are doing this and are helping us to develop and to establish a little bit more training within the interpreters. Mexico can give a lot to the United States when it comes to the use of Mexican Sign Language and the use of the deaf community and its culture. But the United States can help us out creating a program, a educational program, to form and to establish interpreter training program for our country. Now, both of the countries can work together in forming interpreters for the deaf. We can work together, and both of us can be benefit from this new plan that we can create. Mexico offers a lot of culture, a lot of language within the deaf community, and you as the United States can offer to create, to help us organize new programs, new evaluation forms, to develop the new interpreter training program that Mexico needs because of all the experience that you have in the United States. So we're asking, we work together to do that same thing. Sergio Peña y voy a hablar acerca del desarrollo de los intérpretes de México y el impacto que crea en los Estados Unidos. Al igual que en muchos países, son los hijos oyentes de padres sordos los que primero interpretaron en el país. Posteriormente, algunas organizaciones religiosas del país usaban intérpretes de señas en sus eventos religiosos. Pero el sistema de traducción tendía a ser transliterado. Los sordos no comprendían el mensaje transmitido y solo pensaban que la información era muy compleja para su comprensión. Los intérpretes reconocían que cuando ellos interpretaban la información era diferente a cómo ellos conversaban con los sordos. Tanto ellos como los sordos creían que el diálogo era informal y la manera de interpretar era el lenguaje más formal. Pero con el transcurso del tiempo, algunos intérpretes recibieron capacitación en la ciudad de San Diego, California. Y esto fue con el fin de recibir información en el área de interpretación religiosa. Ahora, benefició a muchos que estaban interesados en el área de intérpretes de señas mexicanas, debido a que podían recibir dicha instrucción por vivir en frontera, ellos compartieron esta instrucción con otros intérpretes y empezaron a capacitar a otros intérpretes de la ciudad. Y esto fue un paso muy grande para los que estaban interesados en mejorar sus habilidades. Ellos se dieron cuenta que el método de interpretación de Estados Unidos no era el mismo método de transliteración que se estaba usando en México. Ahora, haciendo un paréntesis, recordemos que Estados Unidos tiene mucha experiencia en el ámbito de interpretación, porque es un país multilingüe, cuando México tiende a ser un país monolingüe. Aunque hay comunidades indígenas que hablan dialectos, no es la necesidad mayoritaria en las ciudades grandes. Por eso la experiencia de interpretar no era muy conocida en ese entonces y no tenían mucha experiencia al respecto. Por eso este nuevo método de interpretar y no de transliterar se empezó a hacerle difusión a otros intérpretes que después lograron hacer intérpretes cualificados de México. Posteriormente, del 21 al 23 de abril de 1995, un grupo de intérpretes e intérpretes en formación se reunieron en la Ciudad de México para establecer una asociación de intérpretes en acorde con la instrucción adquirida de un intérprete religioso que asistió al Congreso de Intérpretes de Sordos de Latinoamérica que se llevó a cabo en Santa Fe, Bogotá, Colombia. En esta reunión se fundó la Asociación Nacional de Intérpretes de la Lengua de Signos, que sus siglas es ANILS. Esta asociación ha estado dando seguimiento al desarrollo del uso de la lengua de señas mexicanas y al ir investigando lingüísticamente se ha demostrado que es la lengua natural del sordo mexicano. Esta asociación lleva varios años estableciendo parámetros como el código ético del intérprete, talleres de capacitación, certificación de apoyo. Ahora, en este momento está enfocado a la educación del uso correcto de la lengua de señas en la comunidad sorda. Debido a que ANILS aún está en difusión, muchos intérpretes todavía proveen servicios de forma particular y no están afiliados a esta asociación. Actualmente existen muchas instituciones donde usan sus propios peritos de intérpretes de señas. Pero a nivel nacional creemos contar con solo aproximadamente 35 intérpretes cualificados que usan la lengua de señas mexicana hábilmente. Entre ellos están algunos conocidos como los CODAS o los hijos oyentes de padres sordos. Por el momento hay mucho que recorrer en el desarrollo profesional de los intérpretes para los sordos aquí en México. Las escuelas están viendo esta necesidad y se está dialogando al respecto. Se cuenta ahora con beneficencias privadas que aportan muchos programas que están en función, por ejemplo, en el estado de Baja California, en el Distrito Federal de México, en la ciudad de Monterrey, Nuevo León, en el estado de Sonora y quizás algunos otros. El que otros países aporten instrucción, como algunos seminarios que dan soporte o apoyo para esta investigación, puede también beneficiar a México. México tiene mucho que aportar a los Estados Unidos y puede ayudar a los intérpretes a crear enseñanza de la lengua de señas mexicanas en la cultura del sordo, pero Estados Unidos puede hacer mucho para México al ayudarnos a crear un programa de educación en la capacitación de formación de nuevos intérpretes para sordos. Los dos países pueden trabajar juntos y salir beneficiados de manera plena y completa. México ofrece a Estados Unidos mucho en la cultura, la lengua de señas mexicana de los sordos, y ustedes, Estados Unidos, pueden ofrecer mucho en la creación y organización de programas, evaluaciones y formaciones de intérpretes para los sordos en México. Por eso, el trabajar en equipo puede salir beneficiado a ambos países y puede crear un impacto positivo tanto para Estados Unidos como para México.